Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to design a simple bicycle air horn. We will design each and every part and assemble at the end of this video. I hope you like it. So let's see how to do in SolidWorks. Now here let's make the first part of air horn bugle. So let's start. Choose your 3D sketch directly. Select front plane, normal. Select a line and draw a horizontal line. Then go back this part and it will automatically convert into a circle. Then draw a straight line. Exit. Now select these three points and make relation along y-axis. Now let's define the dimension. (105.42 mm) 23.6621 mm, and the length 60.8141. Okay. Now, make sure you selected front plane. Choose line again. Select this point. Go back to this point and it becomes a circle. Now, do one thing. Just press tab. Once you press tab, press your mouse center key and drag this. Now, see, it's draw a taper angle. Exit. See, we draw this circle in some particular angle. Now again choose front plane, normal. Now we will define this. See carefully how to define. First select center line and draw one center line. Exit. Now make little adjust. Again choose center line. Now connect this point and this point. Exit. Now define the angle. (25.38 mm). Select this radius. (21.7068 mm). Okay. Select normal. Select line and select this point. Exit. Make sure OK. Select these two points, line, and make relation tangent. OK. Select distance. (106.1141 mm). Okay. Now this is our 3D geometry. It is the shape and it is the path for air horn body. Simply exit from the sketch. Now we will create three planes here. Choose plane. First select this line and select this center point, this initial point. Okay. Again select this line, plane. Now select this end point. Okay. Now here we created two planes. Okay. Now select this face sketch. Select circle and here draw a circle. Little adjust. And let's define the diameter. 23.20.67. Now exit from the sketch. Now select this plane 2 sketch, select circle and here draw a circle. Zoom. Now let's define this. Okay. Now exit. Now we created two paths. Go to feature and select first lofted boss base. Here sketch 2 selected. Now select the sketch 3. Drag this. Okay. It's looking nice. Select OK. Now this is the lofted command. With the help of lofted command we make this. Now select this face sketch. Select convert entity. Now this circle is converted. Exit. Go to feature. Select sweep to boss base. This profile here selected. Just select the path. Now you can see. We selected this path, select here, OK. Now hide all the planes. See here, the body is here selected. Just find out where is this is the front plane. So select front plane, sketch, normal. Select directly line and start from this point to draw a vertical line. Exit. Now define the dimension. (34.43 mm). (40.88 mm). Okay, this is the dimension. Now choose circle, small circle, or better to select center point arc. Select this end point as a circle. Select this point and draw a circle up to here. Exit. Select a line, connect up to here. Exit. Choose a spline. Select this point and connect with this point. Exit. Now this is a perfect shape. It is up to you whatever shape you want. I will choose this radius 1.25 mm. Select here, OK. Now just try to revolve this body. Go to feature, select here, revolve boss base. Select this bottom line as an axis, OK. Now you can see, we created a nice body. Now we want to make this hollow. First make fillet. 1 mm and select this corner sharp edge. Okay. That's it. Now choose fillet. We want to make this should be hollow. Select this end and select last end. Show preview. Select here, okay. Okay, now see our bugle is hollow. You can see it here. Now here we will add some portions. Choose front plane, sketch, normal. Select here circle. Just find out this center point and draw one circle here. Okay. And select this point and in between draw one circle. And in this corner draw one circle. Now let's define. (1.86 mm), (2.15 mm), and this bigger one (3.62 mm). Okay, choose center line and draw one center line. Exit. Now choose here revolve boss base. See, this line is selected and these circles are going to revolve 360 degree. Okay, it's calculating. Now it's done. See, it's a rib created. Now let's I will give some warm kitchen. Go to I'll prefer to give, actually it should be polished bronze, but it looks a very dark. I prefer gold color. See, this looks very nice. You can see it here. Now let's save this part. Save part 1. Go to desktop, create one folder, air horn. Select this air horn and make this first part bugle. Part number 1. Now let's create the another part, fittings, clamps and rubber bulb. Now here let's make the next part, rubber bulb. Choose front plane, sketch, select center line, draw a horizontal line here, select a line. Convert it into a arc, then again convert it into a circle and select this line. Now select the center point of this circle and this line, make relation coincide. Okay, select this line, construction geometry. Now let's define. (11.6076×2 mm). Select this 6 mm (29.74 mm) the radius. Okay. Now do one thing, select this line and delete it. Go to sketch, choose, take little upward. Now choose spline and select this point. Exit. Now select this point. Adjust according to your requirement. Choose smart dimension and select the overall length 83.62 mm. Okay. Choose offset entity. Select 0.62 mm and select this edge. Make sure it is outside. Okay. Choose a line. And connect it one end, close the another end. Okay, again choose a line and close this end also. Exit. Now here let's try to revolve. Revolve boss base, select this bottom line as a axis. Okay. Now save this as a part number 2 rubber bulb. So this is our second part. Let's do the next part, rubber clamp. Let's make the third part clamp. Choose front plane and draw two circles from origin point. Now let's define 13.81 mm, 12.81 mm. Draw one center line. Choose line. Connect with this line. And connect with this line. Now let's define keep the length 2.75 mm. This width (14.81 mm). Now let's try 5.5 mm. Okay. Choose trim entity and trim this inside faces. Just make undo. Choose mirror entity and select these three lines. Just mirror about this line. Okay. Choose the gap 0.2 mm. Okay. Trim entity and trim this inside lines. Okay. Now this is perfect. Okay. Now this is the separate body. Select extruded boss. extrude up to 5 mm. Okay. Choose fillet 0.5 mm and select this edge. Select this face, sketch normal. Let's draw a center line. Select circle and draw a circle here. Make the diameter 3 mm. Okay, and select extruded cut and make a throughout hole. Okay, fill it. Select 1 mm. Select all the corners. Now let's define this material. Go to brass. Okay, let's make polished brass. This is the third part, so save it. Part number 3, clamp. Now let's start the assembly of air horn. Now here let's start the assembly of air horn. Choose new assembly. Okay, this is the SolidWorks assembly window, so we will first browse the parts. We prefer bugle first part and rubber bulb second part. Okay, this is the bugle and rubber bulb. I prefer background warm kitchen. Let's rotate the bulb. Choose mat. Select the inside face of bulb and upper side of rod. Okay. Now choose this outer edge and this edge. Clear. This inside edge and outer edge, make coincide. Okay, now here the rubber fix with this bugle. Okay, now let's bring the last part, clamp. Select the inside face mat, the upper face, coincident relation. Okay, now select this face and this face, make gap 0.5 mm. Okay, now see, this is our bugle. Now here we will fix the screw. So just go to design library, select toolbox, go to NC matrix, bolt and screw, and select machine screw. I'll prefer here to fix a screw. Now do one thing, just drag this pan cross head screw and select this hole. Now see, it's showing. Select M3. Select 2.5 mm. Length make 3 mm. Thread length also keep 3 mm. schematic. Select OK. Select cancel. Now select this face mat, this face concentric relation. Okay, now it is fixed. See, this is machine screw, so you can screw it by a screwdriver. Okay, so this is your simple project air horn. I hope you like it. Please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks, and don't forget to share and like our video. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.